Hello everyone, in my today's video I will show you how to draw hexagonal crystal structure. I will draw the crystal structure of zinc sulfide, which include two atoms. One is zinc and the other is sulfate or zinc sulfide. In hexagonal crystal structure, the alpha is equal to beta is equal to 90 degree, where the angle gamma is equal to 120 degree. The space group for such a structure is P63MC, and the position of zinc in zinc sulfide unit cell are 0.33, 0.66 and 0.00, where the position of sulfide or sulfate inside the unit cells are 0.3, 0.6 and 0.375. Okay, let's start. Go to file, open Vesta. Vesta is a software which is designed for visualization for electronic and structure analysis. Go to file, click on new structure, name it as ZnS. Go to unit cell, in unit cell select space group P63MC. First click here on hexagonal and select 186. This one is space group of hexagonal crystal structure. Here you see these windows are automatically updated. Sorry, here I forgot to mention the bond lattice parameters. In hexagonal crystal structure, the two lattices A and B are equal, while the C parameter or the third side is larger than or smaller than the other two. The lattice parameters of ZnS are A is equal to 3.8, B is equal to 3.8 and C is equal to 6.23. Here lattice parameters are lattice distances. A is equal to 3.8, B is equal to 3.8 and C is equal to 6.23. Okay, enter these values here. The lattice parameter A is equal to 3.8. Here you see the angle parameter B is automatically updated because we have entered the hexagonal space group, which is 186 for vertzite crystal structure. And now enter the C. C is equal to 6.23. Okay, now proceed to structure parameters. And structure parameter, add new atom, click on new. Here go to symbols and select the atom. First I will select zinc. I will label it as Zn, and the positions of zinc in unit cell are given as 0.336, 0.667 and 0.000. enter these values here. 0.333, 7 and 0 0 0. Okay, now add new atom, select the symbol or the atom S sulfide. Okay, now here enter the position of this new sulfide or sulfate atom S, which are okay, the position for Zn are 0.33 0.6 6 6 7. Now edit this one. Edit the second one, give the symbol as S, and the position of atoms inside the unit cell are 0.33, 0.667, 0.37500, 0.37500. Let's verify it again. Zn 0.33 0.7 0 0 0 0.375 and this is 3 3. Okay, now volumetric data and crystal shape for let these, click on OK. Here you see the Wurtzite or ZnS crystal structure of zinc sulfide. Let's go to bonding bonds. Click on new bond. The bond will be from Zn to S, and the maximum bond length is 2.8 or 3. Enter it. Click apply and OK. Here you see the bonds between zinc and sulfide atom. Object, click on L, again click on L if you want to see the symbols. Okay, show both or Zn, go to edit data structure parameter. Okay, symbol it as S, apply. Now here you see the ZnS crystal structure of a Wurtzite unit cell. Let's make a super cell. Edit unit cell, transform into 111. I will transform into 1 2 2. Yes, okay. Here you see a bunch of unit cells of ZnS crystal structure. It is a hexagonal or Wurtzite crystal structure. If you want the diffraction pattern of this, go to powder diffraction pattern and click on calculate. Here you see the diffraction pattern of ZnS Wurtzite crystal structure or ZnS hexagonal crystal structure. Thank you for watching this video, and don't forget to subscribe for more videos. Thank you.